Hi friends, good morning. So in this lecture we are going to study about the interaction picture or the Dirac picture. Okay. So far we have covered in the last two lectures about the Schrodinger picture and the Heisenberg picture. Okay. In the Heisenberg picture, we studied that state vector is time independent while the operator remains time dependent. Okay, and in Schrodinger picture, state vector is time dependent while the operator like position, momentum and Hamiltonian of the system remains time independent. Okay, so as you can see here, the h cap of t is equal to exponential I t h cap divided by h cut, a s cap into exponential minus I t h cap divided by h cut. So this was the operator in the Heisenberg picture. Okay, so in this, as you can see here, this was the state vector in the Heisenberg picture. Psi h of t is equal to exponential I t h cap by h cut psi s of t, where psi s of t is the Schrodinger state vector. This. Okay. So today we will study about the interaction picture or the Dirac picture. So what is this interaction picture or the Dirac picture? So Dirac picture is something that is intermediate between the Schrodinger picture and the Heisenberg picture. Okay. So in this Dirac picture, both state vector and the operator remains time dependent. Okay, they are both time dependent, they move with time. Okay, so the next question arises, when this Dirac picture is useful, when we will use this Dirac picture. Okay, So the answer is when there is a explicit time dependence of the interaction term in the Hamiltonian, we will use this Dirac picture. Okay, so we will see this later. So it is useful in the quantum field theory and in Feynman diagrams. So in this places, Dirac picture is useful in the quantum field theory and the Feynman diagrams. Feynman diagrams is something, the diagram showing how the electromagnetic radiation interact with subatomic particles. Okay, so we will discuss this in a next class. I will tell what is the Feynman diagrams. Okay, so today we will study about the Dirac picture. Okay, let's consider some Hamiltonian in the Schrodinger picture containing both a free term and an interaction term. So as you can see here, this is h cap is equal to h naught cap plus v cap. Okay, this h naught cap is the unperturbed Hamiltonian which is time independent. Okay, but this v cap, as you can see, this is v cap, this is the interaction term, this is time dependent. Okay, so we will consider this as a Hamiltonian, h cap is equal to h naught cap plus v cap. This v cap also called the perturbed Hamiltonian. Okay, so this is our Hamiltonian, Schrodinger Hamiltonian. Okay, so how we will convert to Dirac picture, that is how we will convert the operator and the state vector in Dirac picture or the interaction picture. Okay, so for that we need this, as you can see here, this, there is a transformation operator exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut. Okay, so in the Heisenberg picture, there is a transformation operator as you can see here, this is the transformation operator exponential it h cap divided by h cut. So there is a little difference here it is h cap, but here this is h not cap. Okay, this is the little difference. So there was the total Hamiltonian. So here is only the unperturbed Hamiltonian of the system, that is h not cap. Okay, so the next task is how to convert this state vector and the operator in Dirac picture. Okay, so as you can see here, I have written here this, look at this line. Okay, so psi I of t, I for interaction picture. Okay, psi of t is equal to, I will operate this transformation operator, this is the transformation operator, that is exponential I h not cap divided by h cut t into psi s of t. And as you can see here, this is the operator a i of t is equal to exponential I h not cap h cut divided by h cut into t a s cap exponential minus i h not cap t divided by h cut. So we have converted this in this manner in the Dirac picture. Okay, so this is the state vector and this is the operator. We have converted this into the Dirac picture, okay, by this transformation operator. Okay, as you can see here, both psi of t and a of t time dependent. As you can see here, explicit time independent, here is time dependent, and also here is time dependent. So both state vector and the operator are time dependent. Okay, so if you try to find psi s of t, what will happen? Psi s of t, it will be this. Okay, psi s of t is equal to exponential minus I h not cap divided by h cot into t psi I of t. Okay, so if you substitute t is equal to 0, if you want to find a time t is equal to 0, you will get psi I of 0 is equal to psi s of 0, that is Schrodinger state vector and the interaction state vector coincide at t is equal to 0. Okay, so our next task is how to find equation of motion for the state vector in the Dirac picture. Okay, so we have this psi of t I is equal to exponential I t h not cap divided by h cot psi t of s. Okay, with total Hamiltonian h cap is equal to h not cap plus b cap. This b cap is the interaction term, or also called unperturbed Hamiltonian. Okay, so now we'll take time derivative of psi of t I. As you can see here, in this step, I have multiplied I h cot and have taken time derivative with respect to dt. Okay, so I h cut d psi of t I divided by dt is equal to, I have to multiply here I h cut, and if you take the time derivative of the right hand side, as you can see here, you will get first this term I h not cap divided by h cut exponential I t h not cap divided by h cut psi of t s plus this term, as you can see here, this exponential I t h not cap divided by h cut into d psi t of s dt. Okay, this is just derivative. So in the next step, what we will do, so as you can see here, this I edge cut and this I will multiply. This will give you minus h naught cap exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut psi t of s plus this term, plus this term exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut whole into I h cut derivative of psi t s divided by dt. Okay, so this is the second term. This is the second term. I have multiplied I h cut with this term. Okay, so this is I h cut. Okay, so in the next step, what we will do, this, as you can see here, you know I h cut d psi of t s by divided by dt is equal to this. Look at this. Okay, so this is nothing but the Schrodinger equation in the Schrodinger picture. Okay, so I will substitute for this h cap psi of ts. Okay, so in this step I h cut d psi of t I divided by dt is equal to minus h naught exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut. And you can see here I have substituted for psi of t s is this, because we have just studied now this. You can see here this I have substituted that psi s of t is equal to exponential minus I h naught cap by h cut t psi of t. Okay, so it is just mathematics, nothing else. Okay, so I have substituted that this and plus exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cap psi of t s. As you can see here, this term remains same. Okay, so as you can see here, this exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut into exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cut, this will give you 1. So we will left with the minus h naught cap psi of t I plus this term. Okay, plus this term, the same. Okay, exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cap psi of t s. So in this step minus h naught cap psi of t I will substitute h cap as h naught cap plus v cap. Okay, so we have considered that earlier. And I will substitute for psi of t s, this psi of t s is this. Okay, so minus h naught cap psi of t I plus exponential I t h naught cap divided by h naught cap plus v cap exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cut psi of t I. Okay, so I just multiply this with this. So this will give you this exponential I t h naught cap, this and this will give you 1. So we left with h naught cap, we left with this. Okay, psi h naught cap psi of t I plus, and if you multiply this v cap and exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut and this, so you will left with this exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut v cap exponential minus I h naught cap divided by h cut t psi t of I. Okay, remember the order is important. Okay, so I will denote this term. Okay, this exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut v cap exponential minus I h naught cap t by h cut, this is v I of t. Okay, this is the something interaction term in the direct picture. Okay, or the interaction picture, that is v I of t. And you can see here these two term will cancel each other. Okay, minus h naught cap psi of t I plus h naught cap psi of t I. Okay, this will cancel each other. So we will only left with this. Okay, this. Okay, that is I h cot d psi of t I divided by dt is equal to v I cap t psi of t I. Okay. So what is this? This is nothing but the equation motion. This is the Schrodinger equation in this interaction picture. Okay. This is the Schrodinger equation in the interaction picture. With V I of t is this. Exponential I t h naught cap divided by h cut v cap exponential minus I t h naught cap divided by h cut. If you studied the Heisenberg picture, you can clearly differentiate between this Vi of t and that Ah of t. Okay, this is nothing but there is a little difference. There was total Hamiltonian H naught cap, but here is only H naught cap. Okay, only H naught cap. So the time evolution is governed by this. Time evolution of the interaction state vector, this interaction state vector psi of t I is governed by this v I of t, which explicitly depend upon time. This, as you can see here, there is explicit dependence upon time. Okay, so this is the time derivative of the psi of t of I. Okay, so next we will notice two things. Okay, in the note one, suppose there is no interaction term. Okay, suppose there is no interaction between electron. So we'll take an example of electron interaction. So if this is absent in the system, okay, that is V cap is equal to zero, what will happen? If this V cap is zero, that means Vi of t will be 0. Okay. If Vi of t is 0, so that means this term will be 0. So that means psi of t of I will give you constant in time. Okay. So this will be time independent. So this will be, as I have written here, this will be time independent. This is not a function of time. This will be constant with time. So in this case, this is similar to something called the Heisenberg picture. In Heisenberg picture, we have a state vector is time independent. Okay, so this is similar to the Heisenberg picture in a special case. So in the note 2, so let's consider, as you can see here, I have written here in the note 2. Okay, let's consider the interaction picture counterparts to the Schrodinger Hamiltonian operators. Okay, suppose the interaction picture, that is the V cap, is itself the Hamiltonian, Schrodinger Hamiltonian, V H naught F, H naught cap S. This is, okay, if V cap is this, what will happen? So if you try to write the corresponding Hamiltonian in the Dirac picture or the interaction picture, That is H of t is equal to exponential, this will happen, exponential I H naught cap S t divided by H cut H naught cap S exponential minus I t H naught cap S divided by H cut. S stands for Schrodinger picture only. Okay, so since H naught cap and this exponential minus I t h naught cap divided by h cut, they both will commute to each other, because this h naught cap will commute each term in the expansion of exponential minus I t h naught cap divided by h cut. Okay, so if they commute to each other, so you can write h naught cap into this, you can write this h naught cap exponential minus I t h naught cap divided by h cut as exponential minus I t h naught cap into h naught cap. So you can swipe between these two. Okay. So if if you multiply exponential, if you multiply exponential my, if exponential I h naught cap divided by h cut, and with this term, with this term, if you multiply with these both terms, you will give 1. So h naught s cap. Okay, so this follows from h naught s cap committing in the itself in the series expansion of the exponential. That means when this is commit to each other, this will give you this. Okay, that means Hamiltonian of the Schrodinger picture and the Hamiltonian in the interaction picture are same. Okay, that means the physics remains same between the Schrodinger picture, between the Schrodinger picture and the interaction picture. Okay, so next to operator evolve in time, that is the equation. What is the equation of motion for the operator? So we have this ai of t is equal to exponential I h naught cap t divided by h cut, s cap exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cut. Okay, since a s cap, that is the operator in the Schrodinger picture, is time independent, you can say that derivative of a s cap by dt is equal to 0. And if you studied the Heisenberg picture and in the last class, okay, the time derivative of a h cap of t with respect to dt, it was something 1 by I h cut, 1 by h cut a h cap t comma h cap. But here is nothing but the same thing, but here is a little difference. I have said in the beginning, that is, there was h cap, but here is h naught cap. So you will do in the same manner as I have done in the previous class. You will get this. Okay, this, that is the time derivative of ai cap with respect to dt is equal to 1 by I h cut a of t h naught cap. Okay, this is the time evolution for the time derivative of the operator in the interaction picture. Okay, so next we will study what will be the time evolution operator in the interaction picture. So let's see that. So if the time evolution operator, we will denote the time evolution operator as u of t comma t naught. Okay, a of t is equal to u of t comma t naught psi a of t naught. If you studied the Schrodinger picture, we have written also that psi s of t is equal to something time evolution operator or the propagator operator u of t t naught into psi s of t naught. In the similar manner, we have written here the state vector in the interaction picture. Okay, psi I of t is equal to u of t t naught psi I of t naught. Okay, and there is many properties in the of the time evolution operator or the propagator operator. Okay, if you take a, and you can, as you can see here in the second step, if you multiply time evolution operator from t naught to t1, then from t1 to t, you will get the same result psi I of t. Okay, and so if you substitute t in place of t naught, okay, this will give you utt of 1. Okay, this was the property we have studied earlier. Okay, this was the property of the time evolution operator. It shows that existence of a unit operator. Okay, so psi I of t is equal to u of t is equal to psi I of t. So next, there is a property of the time evolution operator. If you multiply u of t1 t2 into u of t2 t3, you will get u of t1 t3. That means you can divide into infinite number of time interval. This is a continuous time interval. You can take a u of t1 t2 t3 t3 t4 t5 like that, and at last you will get this case t1 and t3 like that you will get. Okay, this will give you this. Okay, so this is something called the closure property. So if you, we have seen that this u of t t is equal to 1, which is similar. If you multiply these two vectors, these two things, that is u of t t naught, u of t t naught, and u of t t naught t, you will get 1. Okay, from this you will get this, that the u inverse of t t naught t is equal to u of t t naught. Okay, it indicates that there is a existence of inverse. So inverse exists of the time evolution operator. So these are the properties of an operator which constitute a group. Okay, so the time evolution operator constitute a group. Okay. So psi of t is equal to, we have psi I of t is equal to u of t t naught psi I of t naught, and this is called the unitary transformation. This is known as the unitary transformation. This thing is called the unitary transformation, and u of t t naught, this thing is called the unitary operator because it preserves the length. What is the preserves of length means? If you try to find this, as you can see here, I will try to find the inner product between the state vector in the interaction picture, that is psi of t, bra psi of t into ket psi of t, which will give you this. If you take the bra of this, you will get bra of psi I of t naught u dagger of t naught this, and you will multiply ket psi of t, that is nothing but the u of t t naught psi of t naught. Okay, bra means you just take the bra. If you want to find bra of this, you have to take conjugate, then you have to transpose. Okay, if you take conjugate of this and you then transpose, you will get what is called the bra of psi of t naught. Then if you take the conjugate of this and then transpose, you will get the u dagger of t t naught. Then psi of t, that is the ket psi of t, remains the same, u of t t naught psi of t naught. Okay, so as you know before, this thing u dagger of t t naught u into u of t t naught will give you 1. Okay, that means there is you will get this u dagger of t t naught is equal to u inverse of t t naught. This is nothing but the property of a unitary operator. Okay, if you substitute this u dagger of t t naught into u of t t naught is equal to 1, you will get this. Okay, that means inner product of state vector in the Dirac picture is equal to inner product of state vector at time t naught. That means it preserves the length, preserves the norm. Okay, at a certain time t naught, the inner product of the state vector is equal to the inner product at a time t. So this is the this is called the preservation of norm. Okay, so that's why this is satisfy the property of a unitary operator. Okay, so the time evolution operator is nothing but the unitary operator. Okay, so next we will study an important thing, that is the equation of motion for the time evolution operator. Okay, so we will study that. So we have this I h cut d psi of t I divided by dt is equal to v I h of t psi of t I, and psi I of t is equal to u of t t naught psi I of t naught. We have studied earlier these two things. Now what we will do, you just substitute this thing, that is the psi I of t is equal to u of t t naught psi I of t naught in this place. Okay, so you will get this I h cut d by dt u of t t naught psi I of t naught is equal to v I cap t u of t t naught psi I of t naught. Okay, we just substitute that. Since this, as you can see here, psi I of t naught is arbitrary. That means this whole expression is satisfied for any arbitrary value of psi I of t naught. So we can cancel this. Okay, we only left with this. I h cut d by dt u of t t naught is equal to v I cap t u of t comma t naught. So this is nothing but the equation of motion for the time evolution operator. So we need to find what is u of t t naught. Okay, what is u of t t naught in the interaction picture. So we will find that. So how we will find that? So if you studied the Schrodinger picture, we have studied this psi s of t is equal to exponential minus I h cap t divided by h cut psi s of 0. Okay, so this was the time evolution of the Schrodinger state in the Schrodinger picture. We have studied that. So here we have taken initial time at 0. Suppose if our initial time is t naught, so what will be the psi s of t? Psi s of t is equal to exponential minus I h cap divided by h cut t minus t naught psi s of t naught. So this t minus t naught is something called the offset of our zero time scale. Okay, offset of our zero time scale. If you want to start with a time t naught, you will just subtract this from t minus t naught. That is from t minus t naught. So you will get psi s of t. So now we have this. In this lecture, we have studied this in the beginning. Psi a of t is equal to exponential I h naught cap divided by h cut t psi s of t, which is equal to, if you substitute this, that is, we'll left with exponential I h naught cap divided by h cut t into exponential minus I h cap divided by h cut t minus t naught psi s of t naught. Okay, so take care of this term. Here it is h naught cap. Okay, h naught cap is the unperturbed Hamiltonian and h cap is the total Hamiltonian. So, and we know that, psi s of t naught is equal to exponential minus I h naught cap divided by h cot t psi a of t naught. Okay, so you will substitute this. In place of psi s of t naught. Okay, this. So what we have left? Psi I of t is equal to exponential I h naught cap divided by h cot t exponential minus I h cap divided by h cot t minus t naught into exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cot psi I of t naught. Okay, so we have just substitute that. Nothing we have done here. We just substitute this. We have this and we just substitute this. This term we have substitute this with this. Okay, so we got this. Okay. So this is, as you can see here, this is this whole term. That is the exponential I h naught cap divided by h cot t exponential minus I h cap divided by h cot t minus t naught into exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cot. This is the time evolution operator for the Dirac picture, because we have operated this thing on the psi i of t naught, we will get psi i of in a later time t. So this is the time evolution operator. This u of t naught is equal to exponential I h naught cap t divided by h cot exponential minus I h cap divided by h cot t minus t naught into exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cot. Okay, so if you want to take the dagger of u of t naught, you will get this, because if you want to take the dagger of this, you will use this property a b c whole dagger is equal to c dagger b dagger a dagger. You will first take the dagger of this, then you multiply with this, which is the dagger, and this after doing the dagger, after calculating the dagger. Okay, so you will get this. That is the exponential I h naught cap t divided by h cot dagger. Means first you will take this part, you will conjugate this. Okay, so you will write this after conjugating. So exponential I h naught cap t divided by h cot, then you will conjugate of this term, exponential I h cap divided by h cot t minus t naught, then this term. Okay, so exponential I minus I h naught cap t divided by h cot. So if you multiply these two terms, u dagger, you will get 1. Definitely you will get 1. Because if you first take u, then u dagger, first this and this will give you 1. After that, then this and this will give you 1. Then this and this will give you 1. So u dagger is equal to 1. From here you can find that. U dagger of t naught is equal to u inverse of t naught. So this is nothing but the property of a unitary operator. So we can also prove here that is the time evolution operator is a unitary operator. Okay. So our aim was to find the solution for the utt naught. This is what the equation of motion of the time evolution operator. We want u of t naught. So we got this. we have got this result. This, as you can see here, this is the solution, formal solution of the time evolution, time derivative of the time evolution operator. U of t t naught exponential I h naught cap divided by h cot t exponential minus I h cap divided by h cot t minus t naught into exponential minus I h naught cap t divided by h cot. You should be very careful that about these two terms. Here it is h naught cap. Here it is h naught cap. That is the unperturbed Hamiltonian, or the which give unperturbed Hamiltonian means which gives the exact solution. Okay, so this is the total Hamiltonian which consists of the unperturbed Hamiltonian plus the interaction term, that is the v cap term. Okay, v cap also known as the perturbed Hamiltonian. Okay, so u of t t naught consists of these things. You should be very careful that. Okay, you should be very careful about this. So this is the solution of the equation of motion. This is the solution, as you can see here, I have marked here in the arrow mark. This is the formal solution we have got. So we have studied this. So let's summarize between these three pictures. Okay, three pictures. We'll summarize this. So in the Schrodinger picture, what we have studied in the Schrodinger picture, first state vector is time dependent while the operator is time independent. Okay, and in the Heisenberg picture, this is the Heisenberg picture, state vector is time independent but the operator is time dependent. Okay, so and the Dirac picture, that is the interaction picture, is something between the intermediate between the Schrodinger picture and the Heisenberg picture. Okay, so this is in the interaction picture, both state vector and the operator are time dependent. Both state vector and the operator time dependent. Okay, hope you will understand everything. Okay, thanks for watching. We'll meet in the next class. Okay.